Does your law firm get paid before you perform the services for the clients? Well, then you should watch this video, How to Record Receiving Clients' Payments. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Law firms get paid a little differently from the average company. Payments are usually received before services are rendered to the clients. Each payment changes the balance in the chart of accounts and the balances of the individual client, and those are two separate sets of records in your QuickBooks Online. For example, let's imagine on January 1, we received $6,000 from Alan Arby, who gave you check number 6161 for future services rendered. And to make things easy, let's imagine that you immediately deposited the check into your operating bank account. So what would change in the trial balance at the moment that you record this very first transaction? Well, you have more money in your bank account, so cash in Chase Bank would increase. At the same moment, you owe money to the client in the form of future legal services, and the amount owed to the client in the future for legal services that you owe them would increase. Because if they pay you before you do the service, you owe them more services in the future at the moment that you received payment. You should also be aware that the customer's individual balance would change in the customer's records aside from the trial balance and the chart of accounts. So, let's take a look at this transaction. We do receive payment. Now, before I record this, I'd like to click Reports, Custom Reports, and go to the trial balance so that the trial balance will show the results immediately after we record this first payment. To record any transaction, you go to the top left where you have the plus sign next to the word New. Click once and you see all of your client-related transactions are in this left column here. We then click Receive Payment because you received the payment from the client. Now you have to put each field's piece of data very carefully. You have to choose the correct client, click the pull down, click on the client. This is just reminding you that you're getting paid before you rendered the service. And it's a warning because usually it's the other way around. And we can close this warning because we know the context of what we're doing. So we can go forward. I'm going to use the year 2021 because I'm recording this now at the end of 2020. Doesn't matter. The payment method is check, and it's check number. Now you must look very carefully to make sure that you're recording it into the correct bank account. Cash in Chase Bank is the operating bank account, and the amount of money that you received was $6,000. Push tab. Now we've recorded every piece of data that we need to at the moment that we receive payment from the client. If we click the pull down arrow and then go up to save and close. This is just, again, reminding you, let's click don't show me again, because normally you would have an invoice before the payment, but usually not if you're an attorney. So we click save as a credit. And at the moment we look at the trial balance, cash in Chase Bank shows up for the first time as $6,000 and unearned legal fees shows up for the first time as $6,000. Now we have only checked the results in the chart of accounts. We should also check the customer records. Click Reports, and first we should go to Transaction List by Customer. Transaction List by Customer, right here, and basically it just lists one transaction for $6,000. But if we click Reports and Open Invoice, we see that Alan has a negative balance because he paid in advance. And QuickBooks considers a customer's money who pays in advance as a negative number, because normally a positive balance in a normal business with a normal customer would mean that the customer owes us. But a negative balance for the customer means we owe the customer for future services. Now let's take a look at example two. On January 2nd, we received $8,000 from Betty Boop, who gave you a transfer directly into your Chase bank account, transfer number 12345. So what will be the result? Well, cash in Chase Bank will increase from $6,000, going up by $8,000, and it will become $14,000. And unearned legal fees will also increase because we now owe more future services as a result of getting paid before we perform the service. So let's go ahead and record this $8,000 from Betty. Same thing, we click New, Receive Payment, change the date to the date that the money went into the bank account, make sure it goes into the correct bank account, make sure you choose the correct customer, Betty. She doesn't have any invoices, which is normal for a law firm, but not a normal business, so we close this out. The payment method was, you know, you can just leave it blank and just put the transaction number. And now the money amount that Betty gave us, push tab, $8,000. Now that we have carefully put each piece of data for this payment from Betty, we click Save and Close, and you can see that the open invoice reflects that we owe Betty $8,000 in future services. We also still owe Alan $6,000 in future services. So the total unearned that we owe to all clients is $14,000. And if you click Reports, Trial Balance, you will see that unearned legal fees is equal to the total balance of all clients, $14,000. Our third example involves Candy Charles. Let's imagine on January 3rd, we received $11,000 from Candy Charles, who gave you a transfer to Chase Bank number 09876, and clearly this is for future services rendered. So let's record it the same way we did the others. We click New, Receive Payment, we choose the correct customer, we know she does not have any invoices, so let's close this. We make sure the money is being deposited to the correct bank account. We make sure we put in the correct number. And the most important thing is the money amount, $11,000. Push Tab on your keyboard to save one field without saving the entire window and closing it out. Now that we put every important piece of data, we click Save and Close, and you can see we now have Candy Charles in our list of customer transactions. You can check the accumulated totals by clicking Reports and go to Open Invoice, and you see that the current balance of all three clients equals $25,000. That's the total that is currently unearned from clients. So if we click Reports and we go Trial Balance, unearned legal fees is properly stated at $25,000. And so far, what we've recorded as bank transactions equals $25,000. Now, here's the beautiful thing. You can open and change any transaction directly from the trial balance. You see, right now these numbers are summary totals of all the transactions that have been recorded in the accounts. But if you are looking at a summary total and you wish to see every transaction that adds up to that total, all you have to do is double click the number and you will get a list of every transaction that adds up to that total. It gets even better. When you look at a list of transactions in a report, you can click anywhere on the line of any transaction, double click, and you will go right back to the very window that that same transaction was recorded in. Once you go back to that window, you can make whatever change you want. And if you change a money amount, as soon as you click Save and Close, the results in the reports will change immediately. This report came from the trial balance. Reports, trial balance, double-click the summary number to get the detail of every transaction. Double-click anywhere on the line to go back to the same window that you recorded that transaction and change whatever you want. You can also open these transactions by clicking Reports, Transaction List by Customer, and they're listed here the same way. As long as they're listed one by one, you can click anywhere on the line of the transaction and go back to that same window and change anything you need. So fixing a mistake in QuickBooks Online is easier than erasing with a pencil.